So in continuation with what we were doing in the past few lectures, we were looking discretizing things for parabolic and elliptic partial differential equations. So you guys are should ask a question. I mean, why I am only concerned with partial differential equations? Why not ODEs? So ODEs are in general easy to solve, where PDEs are not easy to solve. So that is why we need to discretize things, and we need to apply some standard schemes. After that, the solution can be numerical solution can be seen. Whereas ODE is a simple equation, and it can readily be solved using standard algorithms such as Runge-Kutta, Euler method, and in your numerical technique course also you might have learned these things. And most of the fluid phenomena or fluid and heat transfer phenomena often occurs in PDE form, not ODE form. Okay, so there are several variables and several independent and dependent variables involved in fluid flows and heat transfers. That is why most of the flow scenarios would accompany PDEs. That is why we are more concerned in solving PDEs rather than ODEs in this particular course. And in the last lecture, we were looking at the stability aspect. And we looked upon von Neumann stability criteria. So moving forward, today we will look into the hyperbolic partial differential equation discretization, and we'll start with slight introduction, and we'll have certain explicit schemes to discretize it, namely FTCS, Euler FTCS, upwind scheme, Lax midpoint leapfrog method, and Lax bandorf method. These are few some of widely used methods. We also have implicit schemes, which is always stable. I mean, no need to take care of your diffusion number. Here, diffusion number is will not be there. There is here another parameter will be there called current number. We'll talk about. Whereas in explicit schemes, you need to take care of your current number. Current number should be less than equal to 1. I mean, this also comes from your stability criteria. So in implicit scheme, we have Euler BTCS backward in time and central in space, Crank-Nicolson and McCormick schemes. So after finishing this hyperbolic partial differential equation, we will move towards solving Navier-Stokes equation. Although we cannot solve right away the three-dimensional Navier-Stokes equation, but we will try to move step by step. So in Navier-Stokes equation, you have left hand side, you have unsteady and convection terms, and right hand side you have pressure term and diffusion term or viscous dissipation term. So the first in solving the full Navier-Stokes equation, the first steps to solve your unsteady and convection alone equation, and that would give me something called inviscid Berger's equation, that too in inviscid form. We will look upon first one dimensional viscous Berger's equation. We will add viscosity in it, and we'll try to see and discretize it. And then two-dimensional. So this could be x momentum, we could have y momentum, same equation, and we can look things into coupled manner. And we will talk the full Navier-Stokes equation discretization. There are two algorithms that there are two approaches mainly are more widely used. One is primitive approach and another is stream function vorticity approach. And then in the due course I will try to explain these things. So the hyperbolic equations, so the most simple form of any hyperbolic equation, we could think of one-dimensional wave equation. And this would read as dou u by dou t is equal to minus a times dou u by dou x. So here there are no second order derivatives that are present in the system, only first order in time and first order in space. And this is your, this falls under hyperbolic partial differential equation. And if you think of it as a real problem, you can think of u as an amplitude. Let's suppose u as an amplitude of a wave. Let's suppose you have a still lake and you start with some initial condition of this wave. So, and this, the amplitude is u, and you have x, and you may have time also, time some axis. So you'll see with time this wave is going to be propagating forward, isn't it? So this, there is a convection that is happening, and the convection is happening due to this guy sitting over here. We will actually solve this wave equation or wave problem in MATLAB also. Or I'll give a assignment to do that. So internal assignment two, I may give as two MATLAB problems. One is heat conduction on plate, and one I will give to solve this wave equation, and you need to solve it in MATLAB or Octave online. This is free. Okay, try to, you have to code it. You first you have to discretize it, and then you have to put the equations in your MATLAB by discretizing things certain domain and with some initial condition, obviously with some boundary condition and initial conditions. You can march in time and space and you can get the solution. And we'll see. If you will not be able to do it, I'll do it as a tutorial. Okay, so the first scheme people have come up with, we start with explicit scheme to discretize these sort of equations. So in explicit way, we have people have done under FTFS scheme, so forward in time and forward in space. So while going forward in time, we can write dou u by dot e as u ith grid n plus 1 minus u ith grid n times step divided by delta t is equal to minus a. So this a is some constant, usually speed of sound. So this minus a, and this you have to discretize with forward in space as well. So I can write forward in space as ui plus 1 n minus ui n divided by delta x with appropriate order of accuracy. I have to check what is the order of accuracy, but it will have some certain order of accuracy. But the key thing here is this scheme is unconditionally unstable. So no matter whatever you choose. Okay, here one more thing I want to talk about is you club these things and you write something that u I n plus 1 is equal to u I n minus a delta t divided by delta x, and this guy sitting over here, and this guy sitting over here, a delta t by delta x, it's a non-dimensional number, and this is called as Courant number, or sometimes also called CFL number. So the CFL is Courant, Frederick and Lewis number. It is named before the mathematicians who come up with this idea. So in general we write it as a Courant number, or also called CFL number. So this CFL number is usually depicted by by the alphabet C, and C is A delta T divided by delta X. So A is your system parameter, delta T and delta X you choose by yourself certain time step, and you have to keep your Courant number less than equal to 1 for stability. Okay, and this comes from for numerical stability. So not physical stability, numerically. Numerically you will have unstable solution. Okay, and it again comes from your von Neumann criteria that we have already covered. Okay, but the thing is, this particular scheme, the people come up with this FTCS scheme, is unconditionally unstable no matter what Courant number you choose. And this scheme, so that is why this scheme is not widely used, not at all used, so to say. So the next scheme is Euler FTCS. So here also I will write. So next scheme is Euler FTCS. So in this, so this was FTFS and this is FTCS. So here this scheme is also, so let me write that UIN plus 1 minus UIN delta T is equal to minus A UI plus 1. So I have to go centrally, N minus UI minus 1 N divided by 2 delta T. And surprisingly, this scheme is also unconditionally unstable. You can also come up with certain schemes, and you can check your stability criteria through von Neumann of your particular scheme, and you can also give something to this field, if you have any idea. People have tried so many ways. Okay, so the first stable stream, you can say, or conditionally stable stream, was first order or first upwind differential scheme. What they did is, essentially this is forward in time and backward in space kind of scheme was there, and people call it first upwind scheme. It's just a nomenclature, you could say. This is essentially FTBS scheme, and this is discretized. The same equation can be discretized in this manner: ui n plus 1 minus ui n divided by delta t is equal to minus a ui n minus ui minus 1 n divided by delta x. And order of accuracy was delta x and delta t. And with von Neumann stability criteria, we have seen that this scheme is stable when c is equal to a delta t by delta x is less than equal to 1. This guy, if it is less than equal to 1, then only you see that this scheme is stable. Otherwise it was stable. It is more than 1. If at all we took delta t and delta x in such a manner that it goes beyond 1, this scheme became unstable. So you have to be careful while doing this. Okay, so this is my third scheme. Fourth scheme people have come up with, Lax method. And the Lax method is kind of modified version of Euler FTCS. But here, what is the modification we do? We take the average of ui n plus 1. Okay, so what is my Euler FTCS? This was Euler FTCS, and we take this thing here again. So ui n plus 1 minus ui n. So ui n, we are going to modify it, delta t, and this right hand side is same, ui plus 1 ui minus 1 divided by 2 delta x. And this guy sitting over here, we can replace this with something called ui plus 1 n, average of two nodal values, ui minus 1 n divided by 2. So essentially this would be replaced by this guy here. And if you do the algebra and if you do the von Neumann stability analysis, you will see that this again is stable, becomes stable when your quotient number is less than or equal to 1. Okay, no need to mug up these schemes. You just have to keep things in your mind that these schemes are there and you can actually very well apply it anywhere you want. Okay. So the fifth scheme is midpoint leapfrog. All these schemes are given in your Hoffman book, and then you can always go back and check back and forth if you have any doubt. So this scheme is central in time and central in space essentially, and this named midpoint leapfrog method. I don't know why, but this is essentially central in time and central in space. We can discretize in this manner: ui n plus 1 minus ui n minus 1 divided by 2 delta t. Okay, so whenever we go two steps, so this is my delta. This is your delta x, right? So whenever you are going forward in time, so you do I plus 1, some ui plus 1 minus ui divided by delta x, this spacing region. Whenever you go central in space, you write ui plus 1 minus ui minus 1 divided by 2 delta x. So this is how you should, I mean, logically you should think of it. This is central in space is equal to minus a, central in time, central in space I can also write ui plus 1 n minus ui minus 1 nth time step divided by 2 delta x again. And this has, surprisingly, this has order of accuracy has increased. Obviously, it's the second order central schemes are higher order accurate. So this is more accurate. You may get more accurate results, but you have to computationally it will be much more costly because of the accuracy. You are looking at more accurate numbers, and this scheme is also stable when c kept it to be less than 1. Okay, next and the last method in the explicit scheme would be Lax-Wendorf method. So in this method, they come up with something unusual. Unusual in the sense that they try to use Taylor expansion in very unusual way again. Okay. So whenever they want to write this particular guy over here, u I n plus 1, they write this particular node at nth time step in this fashion. They expanded in Taylor series of this particular guy in this form: u I n plus dou u by dot t at nth time step and same grid point I'm talking about, I comma n and delta t, plus dot 2 u by dot t square at same nth time step and ith grid and delta t square divided by delta factorial 2 plus. Okay, so this is kind of saying that I am going to write my u t plus delta t, next time step t plus delta t is u of t plus dou u by dot t, isn't it, at same location times delta t plus dot 2 u by dot t square delta t square by 2, something like this, isn't it. And now what they did is we have this equation dou u by dou t is equal to minus a dou u by dou x. Okay, so what they did is they replaced this dou u by dou t or rather replace this dou u by dot t with this equation over here, and they want to replace this guy over here with by taking differentiation of this particular equation with respect to time again. So they can write dot 2 u by dot t square as minus a dot 2 u by dot x dot t. Okay, so this is replaced by this expression over here. Okay, let me write it properly. So while writing u I n plus 1, I may write as u I n. This is kind of boring, but let's do this exercise, because you should know that these things are there. You should have something in your corner of your mind that these things are there and we can use whenever it is necessary. Minus a dot u by dot t, I have replaced this, right? Okay, since this is equal to this, so I am going to replace this guy with this. So this times delta t is there, plus a square dot u dot 2 u by dot x square. Okay, so here I have made one more modification. So dot by dot x dot u by dot t, I can write, I can swipe the differentials, and now this dot u by dot t can be replaced by this guy over here. So this can be written a dot by dot x, again I can write minus a dot u by dot x. So this can be written a square dot 2 u by dot x square, isn't it? So I'll replace this guy over here times delta t square by factorial 2. Now if we do the algebra properly, if we go by central, so this, oh, so this is x now, sorry, this is x over here. So all these things I will put the discretization and the central differentiating scheme, and then I can write u I n plus 1 as u I n minus a central differentiating iska karte hain u I plus 1 n minus u I minus 1 n divided by 2 delta x टाइम्स डेल्टा टी. तो डेल्टा टी इधर रख लेते हैं एक के साथ. ओके, प्लस हाफ ए स्क्वायर डेल्टा टी स्क्वायर, ऐसा आ जाएगा एक्सप्रेशन आपका. इसका सेंट्रल डिफरेंसिंग भी देखते हैं, यू आई प्लस वन एन माइनस टू यू आई प्लस यू आई माइनस वन एन एन डिवाइड बाई डेल्टा एक्स स्क्वायर. ओके, और फिर ये स्कीम आपका एक स्कीम बन के आ जाता है, isn't it? So this was an unusual way to do that, but yes, it is also applicable, and people have seen that this is your current number over sitting over here, identity layer, and this is also stable if c is less than equal to 1. This comes out to be stable when this satisfies c is less than 1. Now let's talk about implicit schemes now. So far we have looked upon explicit schemes. Okay, explicit schemes. Now we have to look for implicit schemes for hyperbolic equation. And here there is no need of your looking at the current number, because these schemes are always or unconditionally stable without condition. Okay, so the first scheme people have come up with is Euler. DTCS scheme. Okay, so backward in time, center in space, but this would be implicitly, right? So implicitly में ध्यान रख क्या रखना आपको, टाइम स्टेप जो राइट हैंड साइड वाले का वो n प्लस वन रहेगा, ठीक है, दिखा देते हैं. सो बैकवर्ड इन टाइम में यू आई, तो आवर गवर्निंग इक्वेशन इज डॉ यू बाई डॉ टी इज इक्वल टू माइनस ए डॉ यू बाई डॉ एक्स. टाइम को बैकवर्ड जाना है, यू आई एन प्लस वन BTCS new FTCSA. Okay, so UIN plus 1 minus UIN divided by delta T. So left hand side is fine, but A, right hand side would be central scheme, but you have to keep things in implicit manner, means unknown time shift. So this is my unknown, this is my known, this is my unknown. So we have to keep my things in unknown way. So I plus 1 central space. एन प्लस वन टाइम स्टेप यहाँ हो जाएगा जो कि अननोन है, माइनस यू आई माइनस वन एन प्लस वन टाइम स्टेप पे देखेंगे जो कि अननोन है, अभी हमें पता नहीं है, डिवाइडेड बाई टू डेल्टा एक्स. नाउ लेफ्ट हैंड साइड में सारा अननोन एक साइड और राइट हैंड साइड में नोन, क्लब करते हैं एंड वी विल राइट इन दिस फैशन. सो दिस वुड बी हाफ ऑफ सी यू आई माइनस, यू डू इट प्रॉपरली, n plus 1 minus ui n plus 1 plus half c ui plus 1 n plus 1. So right hand side सारे के सारे unknown है and left hand side में मेरे known value होगा जो कि होगा ui n times. Okay, अब हमें club क्या करना है, I is equal to first grid point पे, first grid point पे एक equation लिखेंगे is equal to something, I is equal to सेकेंड ग्रिड पॉइंट पे एक इक्वेशन लिखेंगे इज इक्वल टू समथिंग. तो ऐसे हम फिर क्लब करेंगे. सो दिस इज नथिंग बट ए एक्स इज इक्वल टू बी फॉर्म एंड दिस देन दिस वैल्यू ऑफ दीज थिंग्स कैन बी रिटन एज okay by inversing inverse and times b and you the clubbing would give you a tridiagonal matrix here. Okay, so there is no need of looking at c's over here, so that is a good part. You aapko ye chinta nahi karna hai ki c mujhe kya rakhna hai, delta t or delta x kya rakhna hai, scheme apne aap stable rahega, but formulation iska thoda hard ho jata hai kyunki aapko individually मेंबर्स को फिल करना पड़ता है और फिलिंग ये अभी तक हम मैटलैब में किए नहीं है, एक बार वो भी करना पड़ेगा. सो एक्सप्लिसिट इन मैटलैब आई हैव ऑलरेडी सीन, आई हैव डन इन मैटलैब, बट इम्प्लिसिट मैटलैब में मैंने नहीं किया है, वो भी मुझे सिखाना पड़ेगा एक बार. एनीवेज आई हैव टू मिनट्स, आई विल टेक मोर एंड आई विल फिनिश दिस एटलीस्ट इम्प्लिसिट स्कीम. So another scheme is implicit scheme is Crank Nicholson scheme. So again Crank Nicholson हमें याद है, हम लोग क्या करते थे, वेटेज लेते थे, ठीक है. सो लेफ्ट हैंड साइड वॉज यू आई एन प्लस वन माइनस यू आई एन डिवाइडेड बाई डेटा टू, राइट हैंड साइड में हम क्या करते थे, हम एवरेज लेते थे. तो किस चीज़ का एवरेज, सो there is will be a weightage from implicit and there will be some weightage of explicit, right? So this is nothing but half of some plus half of something, and yahan something hum kya dalte the, ui plus 1 n plus 1 next time step, ui minus 1 n plus 1 next time step divided by 2 delta x. So this is kind of implicit अननोन टाइम स्टेप है और यहाँ एक्सप्लिसिट है, तो नोन टाइम स्टेप पे जाएंगे, यू आई प्लस वन एंथ टाइम स्टेप माइनस यू आई प्लस वन एंथ टाइम स्टेप विच इज नोन डिवाइड बाई टू डेल्टा. दिस इज अ न्यू स्कीम दैट followed by, and this is always stable no matter what CPU you will choose. Okay, then we will leave things till here and will not go beyond. There is no need of looking at other schemes, but we have covered most of the schemes. In the next class, we will look upon the discretization of Navier-Stokes, not exactly, but we'll start with small Bourdieu's equation, which is a part of Navier-Stokes equation. Okay, and we'll move step by step towards Navier-Stokes equation. And we'll try to solve things in stream function vorticity formulation in the real life scenario called lid driven cavity. So एक lid driven cavity एक मेरा problem होता है, उसमें क्या होता है कि मेरा एक cavity होता है, यहाँ पे boundary condition no slip होता है, ऊपर का एक plate होता है वो move करता रहता है. तो यहाँ पे मेरा जो flow scenario है वो ऐसा ऐसा कुछ गोल गोल vortex फॉर्म करने लगता है अंदर का फ्लूइड. तो ये जो फिनोमेना है इसको हम लोग सॉल्व करने की कोशिश करेंगे Navier-Stokes डिस्क्रिटाइजेशन के अंदर विथ दिस फॉर्मुलेशन स्ट्रीम फंक्शन व्हाट इज स्ट्रीम, और इसको मैटलैब में भी करने का ट्राई करेंगे हम लोग. एक अच्छा प्रॉब्लम होगा करने के लिए. एमटेक प्रोजेक्ट वगैरह किया जा सकता है इसको अगर अच्छे से करें तो. ऑल दो एनसिस वगैरह में ये स्ट्रेट फॉरवर्ड एनसिस अगर हम देखेंगे एनसिस फ्लुएंट वगैरह में बहुत ईजी वे में बटन्स दबा के हम लोग सोल्यूशन ला सकते हैं, पर मैटलैब से थोड़ा टाइम लगेगा हमें क्योंकि हम लोग स्क्रैच से करेंगे. ठीक है, फिर आज के लिए इतना ही, और कोई क्वेश्चन है तो पूछ सकते हैं.
सर सर कल वो आपको पूछा था ना, आईए का सेकंड क्वेश्चन, तो सर हमने उसको सॉल्व किया ना, तो हमको एक इक्वेशन मिला. तो फिर अगर हम बुक की मेथड से अगर जाते हैं तो वहाँ पे वो लोग ले रहे हैं सर एन कुछ इक्वेशन के फॉर्म में लेके आते हैं, फिर उसके बाद डायरेक्ट जो है वो ऐसा लिखा हुआ है नीचे के इक्वेशन जो है वो इलिप्टिक इक्वेशन है.
और डायरेक्ट नहीं लिख सकते हैं, आइगन वैल्यू के आधार पर होता है वो. मैंने बताया होगा कुछ क्राइटेरिया आइगन वैल्यूज का या नहीं बताया
आइगन वैल्यू सर हमने उसकी मेथड से किया है.
नहीं बताया था
सर आइगन वैल्यू वाला जो सर आपने
कराया था
एक कराया है सर, उसमें आपने डायरेक्ट जो है ना उसमें ऐसा है कि आपने लैम्ब्डा की तीन वैल्यू फाइंड की है, लैम्ब्डा 1 लैम्ब्डा 2 लैम्ब्डा 3, और तीनों वैल्यू जो है वो पॉजिटिव है, तो डायरेक्टली ऐसा है कि हाइपरबोलिक इक्वेशन है. अब वो दूसरे जो दो केस है पैराबोलिक और इलिप्टिक,
इस केस में क्या हो रहा है, वो आइगन वैल्यूज क्या आ रहे हैं
इसमें? सर हम आइगन वैल्यूज पे गए नहीं है
तो वो करना
सर आपको इसका मैट्रिक्स मैट्रिक्स भेजू सर?
हाँ ठीक है,
दो ही मिनट.
सर हमने दूसरी मेथड से किया है सर, उसमें आगे कैसे होगा वो
दूसरा मेथड मैंने बताया हुआ है, ये थोड़ा कॉम्प्लेक्स है, थोड़ा समझना और वो मैथमेटिकल है थोड़ा. तो अपने हम लोग आइगन वैल्यू वाले मेथड पे स्टिक रहते हैं.
हाँ तो सर मैं आपको ये मैंने सेंड किया अभी सर ग्रुप में, देखिए तो सर एक बार.
ईमेल किया है या क्या किया?
व्हाट्सएप में भेजा
वो सब व्हाट्सएप में. ओके तो आई कैन कल एक बार आइए, क्या था वो देख लेते हैं। एक काम करते हैं, इसको कल डिस्कस करते हैं हम लोग, क्योंकि अभी मेरा एक दूसरा क्लास है। ठीक है, हेलो।
ओके सर।
ओके हाँ,
सर आज शायद डेडलाइन है उसकी असाइनमेंट की।
कोई बात नहीं, हम बढ़ा देंगे डेडलाइन, कोई बात नहीं।